Hello and welcome to this tutorial. My name is Chimango Zinzika. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a WordPress website using local server or offline server. Okay, now this offline server will enable you to create your website without using any internet. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can do that. But please, before I show you how you can do that, I want you to do me a favor, okay? Just subscribe to this channel, click on that subscriber button, then turn on the notification icon, the bell icon, turn it on, so that anytime I have an update, you get the notification. Please do me that favor to subscribe to this channel, okay? Now, we need to get started. The first thing we have to do create our website using offline service that we need to have XAMPP, because we're going to use XAMPP. XAMPP is one of the offline server you can use to build your website. So we're going to use XAMPP, our browser. Okay, now the first you have to do is to turn on your XAMPP, like this one here. Turn on your XAMPP. Okay, this XAMPP here, turn it on. Okay, one here, you can see it's running. So let me stop it, then I'll click on start. Okay, then don't cancel, just minimize it. Okay, now another thing we're going to do is to extract the website folder, the WordPress folder. Okay, now to do that, kindly go to your folder where you have the WordPress. Look at the WordPress here. So I'll right click on it. You see extract file. Okay, so click on extract file. Okay, now as you can see, the file has started extracting, like this one here. Okay, I hope you can see it. Then it will get 100% here. All right, so it has finished extracting. So the next thing we're going to do now is to copy the website folder or the WordPress folder, which is this one here. Okay, or just open it, then copy. After copying it, then you now come to your disk. You see this PC, then click on it, click on local disk. Okay, you see XAMPP here, double click on it, then go to htdocs, double click on it. All right, now paste the folder you copied here. Okay, can see we have succeeded in pasting this thing here. So what you're going to do now is to rename it. Okay, so rename it, click on it, then right click, you see rename, then let's give it a name, site. Okay, now the next thing we're going to do is to create a database for this website. Okay, since our XAMPP is on, go to your browser here, then type localhost. We're going to create a database. When you see this interface, kindly go to phpMyAdmin. Go to phpMyAdmin. Okay, now since you are going to create a database, what you are going to do now is to click on databases here. Alright, then give database a name. Let's give it site 2. The name is site, that is the name of the database. Okay, now click on create to create the database. Database site has been created. Now we need to add a user to this database. What are we going to do? We're going to click on these privileges here to create a user for that database. You see add user account, then click on add user account. All right, let's give it a name, site. Then this host name is the drop down, click on it, choose local. It will generate local host by itself. Can you see it here? Then password. All right, after typing the password, scroll down here, click on check all. There's, you are giving privileges to all everything to this database, so click on check all here. All right, so I'll now scroll down and click go. Good, you have added a new user. So the next thing we're going to do is to configure the website, is to connect the WordPress site to this database. Then how are we going to do it? We are going to click on new tab, then type localhost / the website folder, which is site, then click enter. Okay, we're going to connect our website to this database now. Okay, all right, now welcome to WordPress. Before getting started, we need some information on the database. You will need to know the following items before proceeding: database name, the one we created, database username, the one we created, and also the password. The next we're going to do, as we're here now, we're going to click let's go. All right, good. Here you see database name. This is where you have to enter the database name we created. We name it site. The database name is also site. Then password, I type this. Don't change any other thing here. Okay, click on submit. Good. All right, Sparky, you have made it through this part of the installation. WordPress can now communicate with your database if you're ready. Time now to, okay, now we have connected the WordPress site to the data, to the database. So the next thing that we're going to do is to run the WordPress installation. Okay, now this is where we have to configure our website. All right, give our website a name and the password and everything. Okay, now click on run the installation. All right, so everything you see here is no longer for the database again. This is only for our website. Every details we are going to impute here now is for our website, not for the database again. This site title here, like you see Facebook, Google, like if you open Facebook now, you see at the tab here, like here, you see WordPress installation. This is the title. So if we impute any title here, that will be our website title. Okay, now I'll say domain demo. Okay, now the username, this username is a username we'll be using to log in anytime we want to log into our website. Okay, we're going to use this username to log into our website. Okay, I'll also use demo. Then the password, I will change this alphanumeric here so that I can remember it. Then I'll type demo 1 2 3 4 5 6, demo 1 2 3 4 5 6. Then okay, I can say demo 1 2 3. You see that you will need this password to log in. Please store it in a secure location, so make sure that you remember any password you impute here while creating your own site. Okay, because you're going to use that password to log in anytime you want to log into your website. I see that this password now is very weak. Confirm use of weak password. So I confirm that I want to use this weak of password. Okay, now the next now I will do now is to enter my email address. Okay, demo@mail.com. This is a demo email, not my real email. Alright. Don't take this. You can see destroy search engines from indexing this site. Don't just uncheck it. Don't check it. No, because if you do that, search engine will not be able to index your website. So leave it as it is. Now the next we're going to do is to click on install WordPress. Bam. Let's wait for the WordPress to be installed, okay? Good. WordPress has been installed. Thank you and enjoy. This is our username, demo, password. You are choosing password, the password we choose. So the next we're going to do now is to log in to our website, okay? Now click on login. Good. This is what I told you last, that the username you entered is what I'm going to impute here and the password. So I used demo, then I also use demo, so use demo 123, right? Now click on login. It will log me into my dashboard right now. Cool, very cool. So guys, this is how to install WordPress on your local host, okay? Now let's check how the WordPress site looks like. Okay, I will put it in a new tab. Let's check it out. Good, this is our website now. Okay, so guys, this is how to install WordPress using local server. Okay, so thank you for watching this. On my next video, I will show you how you can play around all those things you're seeing here. I will show you how to install theme, how to install plugins, how to change your permalink and what permalink is. I'm going to show you how you can do all those things on my next video. Please try to subscribe to my channel so that you'll be getting updates anytime I post a video, okay? Thank you for watching this. Please, you can share this video. Click on the share button and share to your friends so that they will benefit from it. Please, don't forget to subscribe to my channel so that you won't miss any updates. Thank you for watching this. See you on next video. Bye bye.